All right. Hello, everyone. Welcome. Happy Friday. I'm Jess, one of the coaches here at Qfitness. Hope everyone's having a wonderful day so far. Today, we're going to go over tips to move more throughout your day. And we'll talk about benefits of movement, detriments of sitting for too long, and then also we'll go through some movements and stretches as well towards the end. All right, so we are now sitting more than ever before, especially this last year. Not only are we sitting more than ever, but many of us are sitting inside. And we don't have to get up and walk to our meetings, to the gym, to our coworkers' desk, or outside to the next building or cafe. So we're not really getting up as much as maybe we normally would. Being at home and indoors, and we may find that we're sitting in multiple hours in a row, and even more than we're actually on our feet. So I want to ask, what's your favorite way to move and stay active, and if you've tried any new ways in the past year? So place your answers in the chat, and then you'll be entered to win a prize at the end. And I'll let you take a moment to do that. All right, so sitting, as I said, for extended periods of time can be detrimental to our not only physical but mental health as well. A few ways it can do that is aid in poor posture. We can get tight muscles, especially our hip flexors and our pectorals. And then we can also get weak and deactivated glutes. The glutes are the powerhouse of our muscles and body. And when we sit too long, they become deactivated. Stiffness in the back can also occur, and also other areas of the body, shoulders and neck as well. So also sitting long-term can lower our energy levels and decrease in metabolism. Then also in decreasing in mental health and overall well-being. And something called upper cross syndrome is also a common detriment to sitting for too long, which is from poor posture. And we're gonna go into that the next slide. All right, so upper cross syndrome occurs when our muscles in the neck, shoulders, and chest become tight and weak. And this is usually, like I said, from poor posture. So a lot of times it'll be like if we're sitting and typing for too long or watching TV or driving, our shoulders can kind of collapse, and then we can become weak in our deep neck muscles and our lower traps. And then our pecs here will become tight. Same with our upper traps and some back muscles. They'll become tight as well. So we want to make sure we're sitting upright when we are doing work and sitting down, and we'll go through some movements later that will help open up these muscles and correct our posture. All right, so tips and movements that we can do to make a change. Our bodies aren't intended to be stagnant, and we thrive when we are put into motion. So every movement, each effort of our muscles to pump blood brings the life force and energy throughout our bodies into our cells, and flushes and removes any toxins or unnecessary things that we no longer need in our body. And there's many ways we can do this, many ways we can help move our bodies throughout the day and prevent unhealthy health patterns, chronic illnesses, and more. All right, so tip one, set up a goal for a number of times to get up from your chair throughout the day. On a holistic health book I'm reading right now, it said that standing up 16 times for at least 2 minutes throughout your workday has been shown to be beneficial to maintaining bone and muscle density. So that could be every 30 minutes. As long as you can get up, stand up at least every hour, that's gonna be beneficial as well. So one way we can do this, if we're forgetting, we can become aware of it. We can set an alarm for every 30 to 60 minutes. And I found an app, it's called Stand App. So if you download that, you can kind of set time intervals and it'll send an alarm or something and it'll help remind you to stand up. And when you stand up, if you want to do something like take a walk around the house or go up and down your stairs, even do some jumping jacks, whatever you really feel like you need to do to get the blood flowing and to move your body throughout the day is going to be really helpful. And also getting up throughout the day is going to help decrease the stiffness and poor posture and help open up your muscles and joints. If anyone has any experience with stand app or if they've used them, you can kind of type that in the chat too. Or if you have any other options, that'd be good to know as well. All right, tip two, make time to get outside. So schedule outdoor walks if you can to get some fresh air. It's a great way to calm the mind and improve digestion as well as mental health and clarity. Getting outside is also a good way for getting natural energy from the sunlight and a great way to improve our mood. Just spend some time in nature and get some fresh air. All right, tip three, virtual fitness class or a training session. So we also offer a virtual fitness class and group fitness program right now, as well as personal training. And we're also doing wellness coaching. So you can do a monthly prescription or subscription for our group fitness. We offer classes from HIIT to Tabata, sports conditioning, yoga, lots of different variety there. And then also personal training as well. So you can sign up to do virtual personal training. We'll tailor it to your level and what you have kind of in, like what equipment you have in your home. And then also if you haven't already put in the chat a way that you like to be active or a new thing you've tried, do that because you'll win a personal training session with me, or you have the potential to win. All right, tip four, do an activity you enjoy. So not only is movement important and physical activity, but doing what you enjoy is also important as well. And it's going to give you more motivation to get up and stay active. Even if it's, I put 30 to 60 minutes, but really if you can get up 10 minutes every day or 10 to 60 minutes or however long you need, it's going to benefit your overall health and well-being. Examples of this are running, biking, dancing, that's a great one that can be fun, gardening, even just moving, you know, planting, growing your own plants and food, that's even an activity. Yoga and playing with your kids, getting outside with them, taking them on a walk, any of those, or I mean, there's plenty others, those are just a few examples, but making sure you do what you enjoy is very important. All right, tip number five, 5 minute movement or stretch break. So throughout the day, if you can take 5 minutes to do a movement or stretch break, you can do it once throughout the day or twice. That's going to be really beneficial to your overall health and well-being. So next we're going to, well, the first one, I'm going to introduce five movements and we'll go through actually three different sets. Each one has five different movements. The first one you can do while you're at your desk or while you're standing. So I wanted to give something while you're at your desk as well, just in case you're like in a meeting and need to stretch or move or something along those lines. So this one you can do at your desk or while standing. So I'm sitting on a Bosu ball. I hope you all can see me. I'm in a good position here. But the first one we're gonna go chest opener with some neck rolls. So we're gonna place our arms behind our back and everyone participate in this so we can learn these and then we'll place a recording on our YouTube channel. So then if you want to go through them again, you can. So interlace your fingers and then press your fingers and knuckles back and down towards the floor. So you're gonna open up your chest here and we're gonna go neck rolls each way. We'll do three each way and try to connect with your breath here as well. You can close your eyes if you need to. So we're going to go down and around and really stretch out our neck and our chest and our shoulders here. All right, let's take it the other way. And one more this way. Excellent. Okay, next one, we'll go into shoulder rolls. We'll go five each way. So we're gonna go up and back and then back around. Inhale as you come up, exhale as you come down. So big shoulder rolls here. We'll take two more this way. And then we'll reverse it. So we'll start going backwards and then come forward, up and over. And then we'll go two more. Awesome. Okay, next one, we're going side body stretch. So we're gonna bring our arms up overhead, and then we're gonna grab our right wrist with our left hand here. And then we're gonna take an inhale and then exhale and reach to your right. Inhale back to center and then exhale, reach to your left. Same thing, back to center, exhale to the right. Good, inhale back to center. You should feel good stretch all the way down the side of your body, maybe in your triceps. One more each way. This should open up your rib cage into your diaphragm. All right. Awesome, okay, next we're gonna go twist. So we're gonna twist the spine. We're gonna reach behind, take an inhale, and then exhale as you twist and look over your right shoulder. Then we come back to center, same thing on the other side. Take a big inhale and then exhale and look over your left shoulder. Two more each way. Last one here. All right, and last one for this little circuit is gonna be a figure four stretch. So I'm gonna have to find my balance here on this. We're gonna place our right ankle over our left knee. So that's an option if you aren't able to get it up that high, you can kind of straighten that leg and then put it below the knee. And then you're gonna send your tailbone out and fold forward. Hinge at the waist and bring your chest towards your shin here. You can even add some ankle circles, but you should feel a good stretch in the outside of your right hip. Okay, then you're gonna come back up and you're gonna switch it out. Same thing on the other side, left ankle over right knee. Send the tailbone back, fold, hinge at the waist, and then bring your chest towards your shin. Good, and then two more times, so just keep We can keep alternating here. You can take an inhale as you switch and then exhale as you fold forward. One more time each side. This will really be good to open up the hips from sitting. Specifically the outer hips for this one. All right. Okay, so next set is gonna be a little mobility flow. So this one, you're gonna have to get up out of your chair and we're gonna meet in hands, tabletop position. So our hands are gonna be on the floor, knees on the floor, wrists, shoulders, elbows all in line, and then knees beneath your hips. So we're gonna take cat-cows to start. Let's do three today. And first we're gonna drop the belly, inhale, lift the head. And then exhale, push into the floor, arch your back, tuck your tailbone in, and then inhale, back, drop the belly. Good, and then exhale. One more here, take an inhale, and then exhale. Excellent. Next one, we're going to stay in the tabletop position and we're going to go into thoracic mobility. So here, you're going to bring your right hand to your ear and you're going to drop that elbow down. And then we're going to open up, rotating the thoracic spine. And then drop it back down. So this is a good one to open up the chest, but also create some more mobility in your thoracic spine. Let's go one more on this side. Excellent, and then you'll switch, same thing on the other side. Drop down, then open up. Try not to open up too far where your hips kind of flare out, so you want to keep your hips in a stable position and really only rotate with the spine here. Good, one more here, open up. And then we'll take it into what's called bird dogs next. Tabletop position, and then we're going to extend the arms, arm out front, opposite arm, opposite leg. So right arm, left leg goes back, squeeze the glute, and then tap your knee to your elbow, then extend again. Tap your knee to your elbow. So this is good for core strength. You can activate your glutes with this as well. Extend and then tap. We'll go one more on this side. Good, switch it out. Tap the knee to the elbow, engage your core, extend. Remember to breathe, one more on this side. Good, good. All right, so next we got two more for this flow. We're gonna move your hands about one handprint above, more towards the front of your mat, and then tuck your toes. We're going into a down dog. So send your hips high up to the sky, and we can pedal out our feet here. The goal is to take 5 to 10 breaths. Pedal out your feet. You can sway your hips, stretch out the side of your legs. Really any movements you need. This is really good for the backside. You want to push the hands and fingers into the floor. We'll go two more breaths here. Good, and then the next one, we're gonna go 5 hand walks. So we're walking our hands up to our toes and then we're standing all the way up. Then we're going back down. Walk it out into a plank. Squeeze your core, squeeze your glutes, and then walk it back up. If you need to widen your feet here, you can do so. The goal is to try to keep your legs close to straight. Walk it out. Walk it back up. Two more. Excellent. All right, so that's a little mobility flow you can do. Should only take about 5 minutes. All right, and then we have one more flow, 5 more exercises. This is more specific for back, glutes, and hip flexors. So first we're gonna start in child pose. Good one to just kind of go inward and also help with your low back stiffness if you have any. Just take a moment to breathe. So knees out wide, sit butt to heels, and then walk your arms out, chest down towards the floor, place your forehead on your mat, and we're just gonna breathe here. So deep breath into your belly, and then let it out. Deep breath into your belly, and let it out. Let's go 3 more on your own. Last one here, and let it all out. All right, next one. We're going on our backs for this one, and we're gonna go glute bridges. So when I was talking about how the glutes turn off and become deactivated when we're sitting, this is a great way to activate them. So we're gonna go on our backs, bend the knees, place the heels just in front of your glutes, and then palms facing up. You're gonna squeeze your glutes and lift the hips. Send the hips up to the sky. Squeeze, 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 and pull your heels towards your butt, and then back down. Lift up, squeeze, squeeze, squeeze. Pulling your heels towards your butt can help activate the hamstrings as well. Back down. Let's go, five more. Push your heels into the floor. Back down. Connect with your breath. You can exhale as you push your heels into the floor, and then inhale as you come down. Two more. Last one, squeeze. All right. Okay, then we're gonna meet in half kneeling. So we're gonna go one knee down, one knee up. This is a good quad and hip flexor stretch. A couple ways you can do this. But we want to tuck our tailbone, so tuck your hip. We don't want our tailbone out, we want to tuck it, and then we're going to push the hips forward, and you should feel a really good stretch down the front side here, your hip flexors, which can become very tight from sitting. If you want to add a little bit, we can reach up overhead, and then you'll feel a really good stretch all down this side here. Okay, we can make it a little dynamic. We can come back and then go forward. Exhale, try to go a little deeper each time. Good. Inhale, come back. Last one. Exhale, push it forward. And you can also squeeze that glute too. It'll make a little deeper stretch. Good. Let's switch it out. Same thing on the other side. Other knee down, other knee up. So tuck the tailbone and then push the hips forward. Come back, and then rock forward. Last one, exhale, push them forward, squeeze the left glute. Excellent. Ooh, okay, we have two more exercises. We're gonna go single leg RDLs next. So for this one, also good for the glutes, good for balance. We're gonna balance on our right foot first, slight bend in that stabilizing knee, and then we're gonna send this leg back and the arms out front. So we're sending the hips back as well. Sit and then push into the floor, stand up and squeeze that glute. This is also good for core stabilization. Extend, push into the floor, stand up and squeeze. Let's go one more on this side. Awesome. And then switch it out. Same thing on the other side. Slight bend in this knee. Two more. Last one, extend, stabilize. Excellent. And then last one, there's actually three exercises. They're Y's, T's, and W's. So this is good for, Y's are pretty good, are good for your upper back, T's, middle back, and then W's, a little bit more of the mid to lower back. So we're gonna slight bend in the knees, send the hips back. We're gonna make a Y. Make a Y. Want to pull our shoulders down and then use our back muscles to lift our arms. One more here. Good. And then to go to the T's, thumbs are pointing out here. Slight bend in the elbows, shoulders down, fly out and make a T. One more here. Squeeze the shoulder blades. Good. And then W. Thumbs to the forehead here. Elbows are bent. Shoulders still down. And then we're squeezing the back. Open up. Squeeze. Breathe with the movement. Exhale as you open. One more. All right. All right, I know there was a lot there. You got up and moved and learned a few movements. All right, and last I'll leave you with a quote from Buddha: to keep the body in good health is a duty. Otherwise, we shall not be able to keep our mind strong and clear, and vice versa, kind of, I feel. So keeping our body healthy helps keep our minds strong and clear, and then keeping our minds healthy also keeps our bodies strong. All right. Does anyone have any questions? If you do, you can type them in the chat box. Or you can ask them through here.
Hi, how did you get this video?
What was that?
How can we get the video?
Oh, like, yeah. So we recorded it, and then we'll be uploading it on our YouTube channel.
If you don't mind, can actually write down the YouTube channel so that in the chat. So that.
Oh, yeah. Let's see.
Yeah, I got it, Jess.
Ryan will do that for us.
Okay, thank you.
Yeah, of course. Awesome. Any other questions?
So these are really good exercises. Is this once a day is good enough for this?
Once a day would be awesome. Okay. Yeah. Yeah, for sure. I see a question. What do we do with our bad side and balancing exercises? I would suggest doing it as good as you can, just like you would do on the regular side. So that'll help improve that balance. And then you'll hopefully be able to kind of create, I guess, symmetry on both of those sides. Hopefully that helped. Awesome. Well, it's almost noon, almost noon. So thank you all for joining. I hope that helped, and we hope to see you in our next one. Oh, one more question. Can you review breathing, when to inhale, when to exhale? I recommend exhaling as you're doing force. So say you're doing a push-up, you would inhale on the way down, you would exhale as you push away and up into the push-up. Also with a squat, for example, you would inhale as you squat down and then exhale as you explode and stand up. So when you're focusing, like when you're doing the movement, doing the forceful movement is when you want to exhale. And then when it comes to stretching, you can inhale and then exhale as you deepen into the stretch. Awesome. Hope everyone has a fantastic Friday. Enjoy your weekend.
Thanks, Jess. Nice job. Thanks for coming, everyone.
Thanks for your help, Ryan.
Thanks, you guys. Bye. Happy
Great weekend. Job. Great job, Jess.
Thank you. Great job. Bye-bye.
Do you have a few more appointments today?
Oh, no, I don't have any, actually. And I had two cancellations.
I've got a couple more. So if Donna, are you still here? I wonder if Donna's still here.
I think she left off. I can email her, though.
Yeah, set up some time with her and then figure out someone from the responses that you think would be good to receive a personal training session from you.
Okay.
Yeah, exciting. Nice job. That was great. A lot of good stretches. I enjoyed it.
Awesome. I hope people participated fully through it.
Yeah. Yeah. I mean, I even did it. I'm at my kitchen table.
You did it? Awesome. Okay.
Yeah, I did it all.
What was I going to say? It's very weird because you can't see yourself. You can't, like, so I'm like, I don't know what I'm doing. I'm probably moving a lot.
No, your positioning was good. Your head and your feet stayed in the video the whole time.
Oh, good. That was the other thing. I didn't know if, like, I was in the video, but.
But you're on the ball, right? So doing that figure four on the ball is tough.
It is, yeah. I was like, you got to find your balance.
You did great. I was like, how is she going to keep her balance on there? I would have been head over heels.
And this one is, like, out of a lot of air.
It's bouncy. Yeah.
It's bouncy. But, yeah, it was fun.
Yeah, you did great. That was awesome. A lot of good stretches. My back adjusted when I did the twist. I was like, I guess I just don't twist enough.
Yeah, that's one that we leave out more than we should.
Yeah, I like it.
Awesome. All right. Thanks for your help.
Yeah, of course. I'll see you later. I'm going to sign out. Okay.